不发疯，或者 it's not crazy， 不太神经。但是呢，好像 investing money 还更就是投资钱去做事情，做社会企业，反而是一个更疯狂的事情。为什么你会觉得企业家宁愿捐钱而不愿意投资钱去做社会实验？就是为什么？比如您是一个比较特别的例子，但是我们知道很多人宁愿不做。
因为我们脑筋里面对于价值跟概念，因为投资要有投资报酬率，那对于投资报酬率都是直接的钱对钱，但是我们脑筋里面，我把它称为叫半盲的文化，只看到现在直接有形，看不到间接无形未来的东西。所以如果投资进去没有钱回来，好像不对。但是我们现在投资进去是有钱的钱，因为这是多出来的，而创造的社会价值，你要脑筋里面有一套思维，你把它转到我赚到快乐，赚到成就，那你以钱为衡量标准的话，那就没有这个感觉嘛。这个是一个基本观念，也是改变了，改变可以改变一切，改变观念而已，实在太简单了，脑筋一改而已。今天听到了以后，大家试着看，改一改，会不会更幸福？谢谢。
Professor Yunus, I was wondering, personal curiosity, how do you come to believe that you can make change in the first place? I mean, like us here, we just think that really we're really weak and we're powerless to do anything. But waiting for the government perhaps to solve the problem, especially system problem. So how do you believe in the first place that you can make a change when you decided that you donate $27, it's less than $900 to 42 women in your communities? How do you know that you can make whatever changes?
First of all, I didn't know. It was a desperate action. When you're desperate, you do things without thinking. This is one of those desperate actions. And you said you look up to the government to do this, solve the problem. In my case, it was different, because literally government didn't exist. Because we are coming out of a big war. Hundreds of thousands of people killed, slaughtered, and everything is destroyed. Factories, whatever little factory we had, agriculture was ruined because of the year-long war that went on. So we still don't have a government function at that time, able to provide a solution. So we are all alone, and here is the problem. So we jumped as a person, but here it is, I have to do something. I had no idea what I was doing. I have no idea whether it's going to work. So that's probably one way to get out of the mindset, because that helped me to get out of the mindset. It's most of the time our real barrier is the mindset itself. We follow the same logic over and over again. We can't get out of this logic. I said, as we go through our educational process, our practical experience in lifetime, somehow we lose our own eye. We don't see what the normal eye should see. We have planted eyes. The school I went, they put an eye on me. The families I grew up, they planted the eye on me. So I see the world in a planted eye, not my natural eye. It's very difficult to get out of this planted eye and get back to the natural eye. That's why education process should be allowing the children, allowing the young people to gain power to their own eye, rather than plant eyes in them and see in a different way. Because that creates a lot of problems. For example, we can't see because we have a planted eye of profit making. So everything we want to understand in profit making. If you ask the question why people don't feel crazy giving donation or philanthropy, but find it crazy to invest in a social business. Because you are talking about business. Business immediately triggers off all the profit, exchange, rate of return, and all those kind of things. If it's donation, it's a good donation. I write a check and I give it to somebody. It doesn't, my mindset doesn't stop. But this one stopped because I have not learned the logic of not making money for myself. And he said very strong thing, if you make people happy, it's for you and also make you happy. And making money is happiness, we all know, because that's what we are told and that's what we built our system that way. We feel happy because system triggers that happiness because of the experience of reading, listening and so on. But making other people happy is not only happiness, it's a super happiness. But we never explore that. Because our books, our textbooks, our lectures, our discussions do not open to that. So all I'm trying to do, open it up. I said, please try a little sip of that. Once you take that one sip, you'll get hooked onto it. It's an intoxication. Once you start getting that happiness, you can't get out of it. You want to do more of it. That's the intoxicated part of the whole thing. That you love that happiness, which comes from making other people happy.
Wow, 幸福之道，幸福之道就是让别人可以幸福，这件事应该是最大最大的幸福。Thank you, Professor Yanus. 接下来我们就请。